Geometric constraints are very useful in a sketch. Constraints and dimensions determine the orientation of the sketch and some kind of relationship between the individual geometries. I will create a sample sketch. Okay. Right click to cancel the last command. And as you can see, we have 10 degrees of freedom here, and the sketch is not fully defined. And by grabbing the geometry, we can move it freely in the working area. In CAD systems, it is worth doing so that the sketch is fully defined. It means that there are no degrees of freedom. That is, the geometry cannot be moved freely. Now, to make this sketch fully defined, you need to use constraints. First, we will use the symmetry constraint and place the rectangle symmetrically about the origin. Select first corner of the rectangle, then select the second corner of the rectangle. And if you select multiple geometries in the sketcher, you don't have to hold down the control key to select them. If you want the rectangle to be placed symmetrically about both the X and Y axis, this must be the vertices of the diagonal of the rectangle. Okay, now select the origin point and select constraint symmetrical. Okay, and now the rectangle is placed symmetrically about the origin. You can check it by grabbing the corner. It means left click on the corner and change its position. Okay. And as you can see, the position of other corners will also change so that the rectangle is always symmetrical about the origin. Okay. Notice there are only 8 degrees of freedom left. Now we will place the circles symmetrically about the Y axis. Select the center of one circle, then select the center of the other circle, and now select Y axis as the axis of symmetry and select constraint symmetrical. Okay, and now if you grab one circle and change its position, the position of the second circle will also change. And there are 6 degrees of freedom left. Okay, now let's place the center of the circle on the x-axis. Select the center of the circle, then select the x-axis. Then select constraint point onto object. And now when you grab the center of the circle, you can only move it along the x-axis. And there are 5 degrees of freedom left. Now, as you can see, the geometries are partly oriented in space, but we can still freely change the dimensions of geometries. And now we need to dimension these geometries. We will start with a rectangle, select this line and select constraint horizontal distance, enter 100 here and click OK. And notice that we only have 4 degrees of freedom left. Now select this side of the rectangle and select constraint vertical distance, enter 50 millimeters here to specify the distance of this side and click OK. And notice that the rectangle has changed color. This means that this geometry is already fully defined and we cannot change it freely. And there are only 3 degrees of freedom left. Let's dimension the circle. Select the circle and select constraint diameter. Enter here, for example, 15 millimeters and click OK. And there are 2 degrees of freedom left. Now select 2 circles and select constraint equal. We don't have to dimension all the same geometries, but we can use a constraint to make the selected geometries equal. And now diameter of this circle is also 15 millimeters and is the same as diameter of this circle. And now when you change diameter of this circle, for example 20 millimeters, the diameter of this circle also change. Okay, 1 degree of freedom left, and we still need to determine the distance between the circles. Select the center of the circles and select constraint horizontal distance. Enter here, for example, 60 millimeters and click OK. And now the sketch is fully defined. This means that we cannot freely change its shape and dimensions. Okay, click close to exit the sketch, select path command and specify the length of extrusion, for example 15 millimeters. Click OK, and that's the end of this lesson. I've covered only a few basic constraints, but you must use constraints to create correct 3D models from a sketch. In the following examples, I will discuss other constraints.